Gonna do a little follow-up on the Honda Civic, the 65 mile per gallon Honda Civic. Give you an idea of what it's been like driving the last few years, what has happened, what has worked, what didn't work quite as well in the long term, and where I'm at with fuel economy today. Using the cord as much because I have to bring an extension cord out from the house, a big long one, it's a little more of a pain, and I'm finding it's just inconvenient. It would be convenient if I parked in a garage or somewhere else, but quite a ways from the nearest outlet. I do use it, just not that much, really just on the very, very coldest days now. Going around the car, you can see I got my grill block is a little bit smaller than it used to be. I take that piece off in the summer. This is sort of winter position. I actually don't need that much air, but this car is on its second engine because I took a trip in the summer, had that completely blocked off. Not thinking about it, I took a trip all the way across New York State, and in so doing, I got the engine good and hot. Not to overheat, but hotter on the temperature gauge than I've ever seen it. And of course, I did everything I could to get it cool as quickly as possible, but the result was a cracked block, a cracked head. And it was just a little bit of white smoke for the rest of its days until I swapped the motor in with a spare that I had that I picked up for about $100. You're looking at, of course, snow tires. Now, I almost never run with snow tires, but this year my regular tires were bald. And it's time for a new inspection, so I had to slap these on here because I had them for free from another car. So they suck for fuel economy. They have brought the average fuel economy down to, let's go look at the meter. The tank mileage for the past 451 miles is 48.31. Now that isn't corrected for the oversized tires. Those are just a little bigger than factory, so we can assume that's more like 50 miles per gallon, which, given the time of year, is really not bad. And my driving's also changed. I used to drive like an hour in a shot, and now I drive like 15 minutes in a shot. So the engine's sort of just getting warm by the time I get to my destination in a lot of cases, which leads to 50 miles per gallon rather than 65. That will go up again during the summer, obviously when the temperatures are warmer. If you're observant, you might have noticed this. This is my internet trick, whatever you call it, hacks or whatever. It is full of cat litter, and this is to keep the windshield crystal clear, which it does help. This thing doesn't have AC, so to get the windshield defrosted when you've got wet boots and stuff in here is a real challenge. So that does not do the whole job, but it does help. You'll notice that there's no fan here anymore, although the the holder spot made some pretty nasty stains on my visor. Mirror is still working out well. You may notice that the car looks a little kind of junkier than it did last time. It's getting close to the end of its life, I'm afraid. This car, I think, has probably got another couple of years in it. I've redone these fenders, completely redone all this bodywork, as you might be able to tell, at least once since the last video, which was recorded about 6 years ago now. I think it was 2011 or so when I did that last one. The underside is starting to get rusty. You notice that the little trim things on the bottom there, I had to take off because they just were holding moisture and stuff and making it rust faster, I thought. So I just got rid of them. You could see some repairs there. So it's good for another year or two. And then I think the rust underneath in this wheel well area and stuff is going to take it off the road. We'll see. I mean, I'll get as many years as I can, of course, but I switched to zip ties to hold these on. There is still, not on this side. This side, the hinge is completely gone, but on the other side, there's still a hinge, but zip tie, zip tie, zip tie, zip tie, zip tie down in that corner that you can't see. This is acceptable in the eyes of the state as far as inspections go, and it's way easier to deal with. The reason I swapped to that is because the threads that were in those holes on the aluminum they were hooked to stripped out and the screws weren't working out anymore, and it was just easier to go that route. I did get rid of the little MPG thing on the back of it. It ended up being, when I had to do some stuff to the bumper, I put that hitch in and had to modify the bumper to make it work. And I have towed with this, although very, very little. It was kind of a failed experiment, but it will tow, just not much. Anyway, I got rid of that at that same time because I was painting, and it ended up being a little pretentious at the end of the day. So there you go. You can see some more of this rust problem it has, and this is actually yet another reason why she's probably going to come off the road at some point, is that these little lights housed are housed in this thing, and this thing is rusting away rapidly. And this is the biggest thing that I wouldn't say was a failure, but was really a big pain. And I'm not saying you shouldn't do this. In fact, I think if you have the wherewithal to put in these underbellies, you should do it. I did it for mine for a long time, but as you can see right now, very little of it is left. I left that little piece there to fill that hole, and the rest of it is actually gone. In fact, including the front one, the lower front one. And this has everything to do with working on the car and longevity of the material. The coroplast was getting really brittle by the second or third year. The metal mounts that it was holding it in, the screws and stuff, were getting rusty. I mean, it would have had to be completely redone. And because I had to do a bunch of other work to the underside of the car at that time anyway, it just was not worth the time. It's worth it if you have the time to do with it. My life is getting a little busier and I don't really have the time to screw with it. So when I need to do a car repair, I need to get to it right now rather than 10 extra steps. The aesthetics are less important, particularly this time of year. A lot of times I'll clean this up in the spring and just put a new coat of spray paint on it. But in the wintertime, everything rusts in Maine because of the calcium chloride they put on the roads. Salt too, but the calcium chloride's the worst. So this motor is, again, a replacement motor from another VX. Really not much in the way of modifications here, just some aftermarket plug wires. Obviously that heat shield is long gone. They rust off here in Maine, and that's the end of it. It's been off of there for several years, never caused any fires, don't worry about it. Over here, one other thing I did cover in the last video that you couldn't see when the re-upload is that I did put some holes in the airbox to draw some air from the warm engine bay, which tends to be better for fuel economy. In this case, it is. And that does help make it a little bit less gutless going up hills. Okay, so the mileage on the odometer is 285. We have to add to that 34,000 miles because this is a replacement speedometer. And which is also dead, but there's an odometer on this, our speed, that little S right there tells you how fast you're going, so I just use that now. But the odometer does still work. So we add 34,000 miles to that, we get 319,000 miles on this car. Gotta love a Honda, right?
Big question is, what's the fuel economy like? Well, this time of year, 50, 55. On a good day, 55, more like 50 on the average. I have had some tanks a little lower than that, 48 maybe. Mostly due to these snow tires and really short trips. During the summer, I'm still averaging 60 to 65. Those 75 mile per gallon trips I don't really get anymore because I'm not doing a lot of highway driving. When I do drive on the highway, it's in that neighborhood, but it's, you know, takes a lot of effort. Without the belly pan, it does cut a little bit down into it.
Thanks again for watching. Please like and subscribe.